My name is Cindy Meyer, and I live in Olympia, Washington. I was not there when Hurricane Katrina struck New Orleans on August 29, 2005. I was not there to experience the panic of water rapidly rising around me as levees failed throughout the city. I did not cling to my roof or attic for 5 days, fearing rescue would never come. I was not separated from my family, wondering if they survived the storm. I was privileged to experience the storm through the stories told by the strong-willed, courageous, generous people of St. Bernard Parish, Louisiana. 100% of the 27,000 homes of St. Bernard Parish were flooded and left uninhabitable after Katrina. 100% of the 67,000 residents were displaced. The people of St. Bernard Parish were left to fend for themselves for almost 1 week after the storm. The first outside aid to arrive in the county was the Royal Canadian Mounties. The people I met in St. Bernard Parish had a life-changing effect on me, and I wish I could return the favor. I will never forget them. These are just a few of the stories of the people I met. I first met Steve when he walked up to welcome me to Camp Hope, a housing center for Katrina volunteers. When Katrina hit, Steve and his disabled wife were in their mobile home, just down the road from Camp Hope. His wife was in a wheelchair, which made a quick evacuation impossible. He told me how quickly the water filled his home and how he took an axe to the roof in order to pull his wife to safety. He had scars along his right leg from the metal shards digging into his leg as he then hoisted himself to the roof. He was lucky, he said, because a local resident came along in a boat within a few hours to rescue them. His wife of 40 years survived the hurricane, but died 6 months later. Steve felt the hurricane was responsible for her death, though. She had heart problems, and the stress of losing her home and all her possessions was too much for her to bear. He promised her two things. He would take care of her beloved flower garden, and he would find a way to help others. So, each day, he goes back to his destroyed home and takes care of the flowers that continue to bloom and grow in the yard. He then makes his way to Camp Hope to help the volunteers. Randy was loading his truck, getting ready to evacuate, when the water appeared around his feet. He said that within seconds, the water was up to his thighs. He quickly climbed to a roof. Shortly thereafter, he realized his elderly neighbor needed help, and Randy almost drowned trying to reach him. Luckily, Randy survived and then evacuated the neighbor by boat to a local shelter. That was just the beginning of Randy's rescues. He spent the next 9 days taking a boat throughout the entire county to assist his neighbors, evacuating them to shelters, and then finding food and water to ensure their survival. Randy's mother was in St. Rita's nursing home when Katrina hit. She was one of the last residents evacuated via Black Hawk helicopter. Many elderly residents of St. Rita's perished in the floodwaters. Day after day, the people of St. Bernard Parish were left to fend for themselves with no outside aid. Randy was part of the local effort to take care of their own before volunteers started arriving to lend a helping hand. He wants all the people throughout the country to know how grateful he is and that they care enough to give their time, money, and help to the people of St. Bernard Parish. I heard there was a story behind the "You Gotta Have Faith" sign standing in the front yard of their home, so I went with my daughters to visit William, Sharon, and their daughter Rihanna. They welcomed us into their FEMA trailer and took us on a tour of their home being rebuilt with the help of St. Bernard Project. William described coming back several weeks after Katrina to find his home destroyed, and witnessed homes throughout his neighborhood pushed off their foundations and scattered throughout the streets. He wondered how to go about breaking this news to Sharon, who was staying with friends in the Lower Ninth Ward. How do you go about telling someone her life as she knew it was washed away? He wondered with anguish. As he looked around, what he found standing was the "You Gotta Have Faith" sign. Although they put the sign in the yard to show support for the New Orleans Saints football team, it took on new meaning post-Katrina. William told me there were many instances of religious artifacts surviving in areas where all else was destroyed. So, this family believes their faith brought St. Bernard Project and volunteers from around the country to their aid to rebuild their home. They view each nail hammered into the wall as one step closer to reclaiming their home and filling it with the sounds of children and grandchildren celebrating life's moments. Like many people we spoke with, they begged us not to forget them and the thousands of people of St. Bernard Parish who still need help. Then they hugged us, waved goodbye, and invited us to Thanksgiving dinner. The facts of Katrina are staggering. The storm swept through 90,000 square miles. The final death toll was 1,836 lives, with 1,577 of those lives lost in Louisiana. Over 200 people died in St. Bernard Parish alone when the floodwaters inundated the area and stayed for 2 to 4 weeks. The failure of the levees was due to system design flaws combined with lack of adequate maintenance. Hundreds of thousands of people were impacted by the storm when their homes, schools, and businesses were destroyed, and they were left unemployed. How does a community recover when every resident is homeless and every business is left in ruins? Miss Leola, a resident of the area, told me that 6 months after the storm, the area looked as though the hurricane had just left. No organized rebuilding was taking place, and people were still awaiting aid. Liz McCartney told me a similar story. She said she and her boyfriend Zach Rosenberg came to the area to help 6 months after the storm and found people who were homeless and hungry. They decided to uproot their comfortable lives in Washington, D.C. and move to St. Bernard Parish to help. 3 years later, their nonprofit, St. Bernard Project, has rebuilt almost 200 gutted homes for the nominal cost of $12,000 per home. They are also opening a mental health center and providing rental housing to elderly and disabled residents. Liz was named 2008 CNN Hero of the Year for St. Bernard Project's rebuilding efforts in the county. Help arrived for St. Bernard Parish in the form of two people willing to help, Liz McCartney and Zach Rosenberg. I met Liz and Zach when I went on my first volunteer trip to St. Bernard Parish in the spring of 2007. Since then, I've partnered with Evergreen students, Caitlin Meyer, Jackie Ferrato, and Betsy Hagen, to begin an Olympia-based group that assists locally in spreading awareness about the continued need for assistance in St. Bernard Parish, Louisiana. I'm proud to say that our accomplishments so far include traveling to St. Bernard Parish to interview St. Bernard Project staff, clients, and St. Bernard Parish community members, participating in Women Rebuild Week in October 2008, organizing volunteer teen and adult work groups to travel to St. Bernard Parish beginning in the spring of 2009, traveling throughout the Greater Olympia area visiting with community groups, and sharing information about the continued need for assistance post-Katrina. Organizing exciting, informative, and successful fundraisers on behalf of St. Bernard Project. To date, we've spoken to hundreds of people. Our goal is to raise $12,000, enough to rebuild one home and one life. But even then, there is much more work to be done. Each time I visit St. Bernard Parish, the generosity and warmth of the residents reinvigorates my drive to continue this work. Each time, they thank us for helping them help themselves and ask us not to forget what happened. Please join us in assisting the work of the St. Bernard Project. Far in distance, but close in human compassion, we as a community can let the residents of St. Bernard Parish know that here in Olympia, we will not forget.